Guys, this is the second part of our last video, and we are creating one web page and small project, and we are covering all other videos which we have learned in our CSS and HTML series. So hi guys, this is Shahban Ali and you are watching Saggy Skills. So let's start.
Guys, in our last video we have created this design till here. So today we are going to continue the design. So as you can see, right now we have this text in this column, but in the left side there is no space, so it's not looking well. So to give space we have to use padding. But guys, let me tell you first one thing. Our screen size is 1200 pixels. Okay, so for example our screen size is 1200 pixels and we are using 4 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 columns widths are 300 each. Okay, the width is 300, so 300 into 4 it becomes 1200 pixel, right? 300 pixel, 300, 300, 300 pixel, all views having 300 pixels. Okay, so if we multiply 300 to 4, so it will close to 1200 pixel. But if I use padding here, so the padding also will take some space. Suppose for example if I comes to my CSS file and this is our div2, and if I use here padding 10 pixels, so what will happen, this width is not 300 now, it's 310, because 10 pixel also padding also covering. So what will happen, see in the browser, as you can see the last div has been moved in the below. This is the problem, because now the total width of 4 columns is going above 1200 pixels, but we want to set everything inside 1200 pixels. So we have to remove little bit the width of all the divs. So for that what we have to do, go here and change the 300 to 280. So plus 10, this one, plus 10 and 280, it will be total width 290. So cut from here, cut it and paste it here. So now one div have 290. So this property we have to give in all the divs. Copy it and cut it and paste here. And paste here. And now the first one is okay, everything. And the second one is, and paste here. So now everything will be adjusted into 100 pixels. It will not go above 1200 pixels. Okay guys, so let's see in the browser. Yeah, you can see everything in the 1200 pixels, 300 290 290 290, like this. And you can see there is a space also in the left side of this text. So now guys, I have to add one image in this div3. So for that, the same things we have to do, we come here in the div3 and background image URL, and the another picture is l.jpg, and semicolon and control s, go to browser. Yeah guys, you can see now we have our second image here, but guys it's not looking well. We have to set position of this image. So background position center, so the image will be start from the center. So now you can see now pictures is looking well. So now guys, the last divs, in the last divs we have to put some text also. And guys, I am designing this from my creativity, so you can use your own creativity, your from your mind, and you use your mind which kind of design you want. Instead of this picture or this text, you can create any other things here, but just I am giving you an idea how we can use CSS and HTML, so only just for practice. And the designing, it totally depends on your mind and depends on your creativity. So guys, in the last div I am giving you another text. So for that I am going to HTML file and copy it and just paste in the last div. Okay, and control s, go to browser. You can see now I have the text in my last div. So guys, now I want to change the background of this rows. Which rows? The second row, this one. Inside this rows our divs comes, like div1, div2, div3. So I want to change rows to color and background color. So copy it, go to CSS file, and after row 1 put dot and paste it, and control and give width 100%, and the height should be auto, because whatever the div insides it will adjust according to its content. And now background color, I am giving gray. Control S, and guys, do it float, because everything is floating in this design. Float left. So now go to browser, you can see now background is gray. But guys, it's not looking well, because I want to change this color, text color also. So for that, go to div2, because our text in div2, and type here whatever the content written in this div, the color should be white. Okay, now as you can see, now we have white color here. So guys, if you want to give border on these images, you can give border also. So for that, go to CSS files, and where is your picture, this one, inside this you have given picture. So here also give border left right side. I want to border only right side, not all sides. So border right 10 pixel ridge. I am giving ridge style, not solid. It's up to you, you can use your own border style. And I want border in the top also, border top same 10 pixels ridge white. Okay guys, and control S, see, let's see how it looks. Yeah, it's great, it's looking great. You can give same properties to this picture one also. So just copy it to save it for time saving. Copy it and give it here also. Control S, go to browser. So guys, now you can see we have borders on our images. It's looking very well. But the guys, the heading is not looking well. See the heading, our products and service, and our product and service. Let's change heading. So for changing this size, what we have to do, just simply instead of h6 type here h4. h4 is bigger than h6, and type here about this picture, about Salman, sorry, about Salman Khan. Okay guys, and here also in the first, change it instead of h6 h4. Control S, now go to browser and check it. Yes guys, you can see now our headings is little bigger. But guys, now what we have to do, as you can see guys, we have created all these menus here, but still it's not complete. Why? Because as you can see now it's an arrow, right? It's looking like arrow, but when I take my mouse on this menu, it's not changing its anchor tag into anchor tag. Anchor tag means like this, go to any sites, Java. Okay, now you can see now it's an arrow like this. When I'm taking this cursor on this link, it's changing its icon like hand. Now it's become hand, now it's arrow, now it's become hand, now it's arrow. Nice way. So to do this, what we have to do, we have to do some anchor tag in our HTML file. Go to HTML file, and after li, open bracket and type a, and type href and close it. And this a is closing before text, but we want to close it after text. Cut it and paste after text home. Now guys, we want this type anchor tag in all. This means become like this hand. If we type a href, okay, so this will come like this hand. So okay guys, now we have to copy paste these things for all menus. Control V and Control V, change its text, countries, products and services, and finally contact. Now control S, go to browser, check it. So guys, as you can see, as I have given anchor tag, so it has already changed its style and color also, and decoration, some decoration applied on this after giving a tag. Okay, a tag means anchor tag. So to remove this text design style and color, so what we have to do, go to CSS file and target a anchor like ULLIA and text decoration none, and color should be white, same like before. So as you can see, our menu is look like before, but now when I'm taking my mouse on any menu, it's changing its icon, like now hand, like now arrow, now hand, now arrow, now hand. But guys, notice when I'm taking exactly on this text, it's changing its icon, but if I remove little bit from the text, so it's not changing. But I want is anywhere here, if we take our mouse anywhere here, so it should change its icon. Okay, so for that, what we have to do, go to CSS file and here display block, control S, go to browser. Now see guys, on this button, anywhere I'm taking my mouse, so it's changing its icon. Now hand, now arrow, now hand, now arrow, now hand, now arrow. But guys, we want to change background also. When we hover on it, it should change its background color. So for that, what we have to do, just go to CSS file and guys, right here ULLI and hover. Okay, when we hover on li, it should change its background color. So background color should be crimson and semicolon, control S, go to browser. Now see guys, when I will take my mouse on it, it will change its background. See, you see guys, now it's changing its background. Okay guys, so guys, it's called hover. When you hover on it, it's changing its color. When 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 hover, like this. So it's called hovering. So guys, menu section is complete like this. You can make your, and you can show your creativity, what your mind think about this, and you can make your own menus and style design. So let's create another section for row. So come here. Now our D row 2 is complete. Now we have to create another row after this div. Div class row 4 or row 3, I think it's a row 2, yeah, row 2, row 3. It's a row 3 guys. Now let's give some div inside this row. Div id d row 4 1 d 1, write like this, write a unique name so that it will not confusion after like if you are doing big project, so there should be unique key so that all ids should not match their name. So row 4 d 1, I have given this name. So let's design first this row. Go to CSS file and after row 1, row 3, paste and then give width 100% and guys, give height auto so that it will adjust its height according to its contents, and background, let it be background white, no problem. Now guys, let's design this also. Id, go to CSS, now come here and take hash and put id. Now width, I'm taking 600 pixel because I want in half screen, and height should be 400 pixels, and background should be background color. Well, let's take background color brown, okay, and control S, go to browser. But guys, we have to do floating for everything. Just float it row 3, because everything is floating. Float left, okay guys. Now go to browser, check it. Yeah guys, see, now we have our next row, and inside row there is a one div. Now guys, one more div we need inside this, so just copy it and paste after this div closing, and change it name div 2, row 4 div 2, okay. So now let's design it also. So here hash and v, sorry, hash, and just copy it and paste here and change it to, and now give it same, and then change its background. Background should be wheat or antique white, okay. Control S, go to browser. You can see guys, we have two divs, but we have to float them. So float left, what will happen, it will go in the vertically now. Float, float left, okay guys. So as you can see, we have two columns here. Inside this column you can create your own some content here like this. If I give some heading here, H3, the products are launching soon. Okay guys, so I have given this heading. So you can see now there is one heading here, and now just write some paragraph inside this. Hello guys, can you subscribe our channel? Okay, so I'm just copy this and paste 2-3 times. CVV. Okay guys, so now let's see. Yeah, there is a paragraph here and one heading. You can change heading color also. Target it, heading 4. And come here, now right here heading 3, and heading 3, so this color should be white. Control S, go there, can you see now heading is white, but as you can see it's not looking well. We have to give some margin of padding. So for padding, use padding here in the default padding 20 pixels. Control S, go to browser. You can see now it's padding from top, left, right, bottom. And if you want to give border like text, T paragraph or text or heading 3, if you want to give border to handle to border 2 pixels solid or dotted white. So see guys, we have given one border to the heading. If we want to in the center this heading, so go here, text align center, okay guys. So as you can see, all text are in center. If you want to give padding also in this heading S3, you can give like this padding 10 pixels. You can see now there is a padding inside this border. So guys, I hope you understand till here. So in this video only for this. In the next video we will continue this designing. We will complete this another column, and we will complete the footer section also. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel. Thank you.
So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share and like. And if you want more updates from our channel, so subscribe our channel. Thank you.